Hey everybody, it's Chris for All Ears TV and All Ears Net with today's Disney Fast Facts. Today we've got your fun Fast Facts about Toy Story Midway Mania. Toy Story Midway Mania holds some historic significance for Disney. The official grand opening at Hollywood Studios was May 31st, 2008, and the California version opened just about 2 weeks later in June of 2008. It's historically significant because this was the first attraction built and designed simultaneously with openings less than a month apart. Just like the rest of Toy Story Land, you are shrunken down to the size of a toy. All of the construction and detail put you on the same scale as Andy's toys. The backstory for Toy Story Midway Mania is that Andy got a carnival game for his birthday and his toys put it together. You can see empty boxes for the carnival game in Andy's bedroom. Disney attractions still rely heavily on scenic painters to bring the Imagineer's designs to life. Scenic painters had a field day working with Blacklight on Buzz Lightyear's Space Ranger Spin, but they had to kick it up a notch for Midway Mania because the attraction is in 3D. So during the painting process, the artists actually wore 3D glasses to ensure that the effects were perfect from every perspective. The attraction opened about 2 years prior to the release of Toy Story 3. Just before the movie opened, the attraction was actually updated so that Bo Peep's Balloon Pop was replaced with Rex and Trixie's Dino Darts. Trixie was a new character introduced in Toy Story 3, and guests that visited around that time got to see her before the movie was released. Buttercup was also later added to the Ham and Eggs game. There are 6 minigames plus a bonus. First, you have Pie Throw. You throw pies at targets that Buzz and Jessie are holding. It's more of a practice game and no points are awarded. Pro tip, this game can really take its toll on your arm, so don't waste a lot of energy on the practice game. Ham and Eggs. You're trying to toss eggs at targets in a barnyard-themed minigame. You're knocking down targets like cows and ducks. Be sure to hit the fox on the hen house and aim for the higher point animals at the bottom of the screen. If you're on the opposite side of the hen house, keep an eye out for a mouse running up the side of the barn. If you hit it, you'll be able to shoot a whole bunch of mice running around in there. Rex and Trixie's Dino Darts. You shoot darts at balloon targets to earn points. Aim for the lava squiggles to unlock the lava flow with high point balloons coming from the top of the volcano. Green Army Men Shoot Camp. You try to break as many of the plates with the highest point values as possible. Look for flying plates to pop up between the mountains. If both you and your partner can hit them simultaneously, the mountain turns into a tank and gives you some really high scoring targets. Buzz Lightyear's Flying Tossers. You're tossing rings around the aliens from the claw game. Get rings around all of the aliens in the spaceship and it turns into a robot. Now when the robot opens its mouth, hit him with as many rings as you can. Woody's Root and Shootin' Gallery. You throw suction cup darts at targets. The big hint here is to hit all of the targets and then when they reset, they'll have increased in value. The bonus game is Woody's Roundup, where you shoot targets on rolling minecarts. The Mr. Potato Head animatronic was the first of the generation of audio animatronics whose mouth appears to form vowels and words as he speaks. The Mr. Potato Head animatronic can also speak more lines of dialogue than any other figure of his kind. It's also said that he holds the record for the most hours of programming for a single audio animatronic. The ride is around 4.5 minutes long, with each mini game around 30 seconds each. There are also more than 150 computers that are in constant communication with each other to keep all the games and ride components working flawlessly. Every now and then you come across a really obscure fact, like this one. In just one minigame, Toy Story Midway Mania typically creates over 1 million broken virtual plates every day. And that's a lot for the virtual cleanup crew to handle every night. Here's some quick tips for Toy Story Midway Mania. There is no height requirement. Children under 7 must be accompanied by a person 14 years or older. FastPass is available. As it's a great family ride, this attraction stays busy. So if it's a priority and you can't get to the park first thing in the morning, definitely get a FastPass. No flash photography is allowed on this attraction. Don't be that person. Guests can stay in wheelchairs to ride the ride. Guests in ECVs must transfer to a wheelchair or directly to a ride vehicle. And there is a step up into the ride vehicle. Guests prone to motion sickness may want to avoid this ride, as the combination of the 3D and the rough jerky movements may prove discomforting. While you wait in line, be sure to use the Play Disney Parks app on your mobile device. You may get a surprise appearance from Stinky Pete. And there's your Disney Fast Facts about Toy Story Midway Mania. This one is fun. It's always on our must-do list. What about you? Do you find it easy to score on this one, or is Buzz Lightyear easier? And how do you feel about 3D attractions? As always, we'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments. Hey, if you liked this video, click on that thumbs up. Be sure to stay tuned to All Ears TV and AllEars.net for more Disney news, fun, and stuff. Follow us on Instagram at AllEarsNet. New to the channel? Check out our other All Ears videos right here. And please subscribe to All Ears Net. Clang the little notification bell so you immediately get notified when we post a new video. This is Chris for All Ears TV. See you next time.